Hey everyone, it's Saran and Steph from B&W Tech. Now Steph, why is there an i-Raman Plus in my kitchen today?
Do you want the good news or the bad news?
Both, I guess.
Well, the bad news is I've sort of tricked you into cooking me lunch today.
Fun.
But the good news is we're going to be doing some Raman spectroscopy.
Okay, and what are we using this equipment for today?
Raman spectroscopy is sometimes used to measure edible oils to determine the different concentrations of the components that are in them. So things like olive oil, vegetable oil.
Okay. And what are the components in those?
We're talking about oleic acid, linoleic acid, saturated fatty acids, and mono and polyunsaturated fatty acids.
Wow, that sounds like a lot. So what do these different concentrations mean?
Well, vegetable oils are gaining importance because of their high content of those mono and polyunsaturated acids, especially in comparison to like animal fats for cooking, things like that. And then also for quality control, we want to determine that the concentrations of the different components are what they're supposed to be, what's being advertised to us.
Okay. So for example, with extra virgin olive oil, you pay a lot of money for good olive oil, so you want to make sure that you're getting your money's worth.
Exactly. So let's go ahead and take a couple of scans of the different kind of oils that we have here. So we'll take a dark scan first, make sure that the shutter's closed, and we'll go into BW Spec here and take the dark scan. Okay, and then we can grab the olive oil there and take a scan of that as well. Okay, and then we'll take a scan of the next one. And we don't need to take dark scans in between because the integration time is the same. And it also works out that Raman can measure through the plastic or the glass bottles, so it's really easy to do. Okay, and as you can see, the three spectra are overlaid here, and they're very similar because they're all vegetable oils, but they're a little bit different because each one has a little bit different concentration than the others of the different ingredients that we talked about. So basically, through this, we can tell that the olive oil that you bought in the store is what it's supposed to be.
Awesome. Well, let's get started.
Okay. Ron, this is so delicious. Thank you so much for lunch.
Absolutely. And thank you so much for watching. If you want to see more of these videos, subscribe to our channel below and also visit us at bwtech.com. Thanks.
Bye.